I still think this is wrong, Basil.
Huh? Nonsense. It's an ancient religious occasion.
It's so silly, so common.
Not at all. It's a special custom for this special day.
It still doesn't seem right to me, Basil.
Huh?
Hey, what's this special day called?
Shrove Tuesday. Show with a big hello. I'd like to start with a few magic tricks.
Basil.
And for my first trick, I shall make my assistant, Mr. Pilly, disappear.
Basil!
Abracadabra, alakazam, scram!
I will not scram.
Oh, you spoiled me trick, Mr. Pilly.
Never mind about all that, Basil.
Huh?
Look at this.
Huh?
Somebody's taken my clothes from my dressing room and left this instead.
Ah, yes, there's a very good reason for that.
Well, I can't wait to hear it.
You'll have to. I haven't thought of it yet.
Basil, this is another of your little tricks, isn't it?
Does anybody tell you you look lovely in that?
No.
I'm not surprised, because you don't.
Now, listen, Basil.
Still, with legs like that, you could always get a job working for him.
Who?
Rod Hull.
I'm not standing here to be insulted,
well,
you know.
Sit down. I haven't started yet.
Do you know, Basil, I could do you a permanent injury.
If you're not careful, I shan't tell you about the great part I've got for you in the new film.
I'm not interested in any... Did you say... a part in a film?
I said it with my very own mouth.
Well, what is it?
It's the thing I speak through.
No.
Sometimes known as a keiko.
Oh, Basil. I mean the film.
Oh,
what's the name of it?
The Return of Tarzan.
Tarzan?
Yes.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yeah, yes.
Oh, Basil, you really are a marvel.
Oh, come on, you're just saying that, aren't you?
No, I'm not.
Well, somebody is. I don't know who it is. But...
Oh, Basil, it's always been a dream of mine to play the part of... Tarzan.
Yeah?
Oh,
Oi, she doesn't do that.
She?
No, you're not playing Tarzan, you're playing Jane.
Jane?
Yes, well, let's face it, you're not exactly built like Tarzan, are you? I mean, our canary could take you on any time with one wing behind his back. And he's been dead for 2 years.
Never mind about that. Look, Basil, I may not look very muscular, but I've got hidden strength.
Well, you're not hiding very much at the moment, are you?
No, Basil, you don't understand. Won't you give me the part of Tarzan?
Well, the thing is, you see, you have to wrestle with a certain animal.
Well, there's not an animal alive that I'm frightened of.
Oh, you mean that?
Yes.
Oh, right. Fred, send Cedric on.
Ah! Ah! Just there! Come on, Basil!
Oh, I've never seen
Basil,
such a cunning
way!
Get in, go on! Go on! Go on!
Basil!
Wait!
Oh, help me!
Oh, all right, all right. Now listen, Cedric. On the count of three, I want you to exit stage right. One, two, three!
Ah!
Yeah?
Help!
You didn't do very well, Jane.
Oh, no, Basil. You don't understand.
Huh?
You see, the snake just took me by surprise.
So it's silly we've been rehearsing for the fortnight.
Please, give me another chance. I'll do anything.
Anything?
Anything.
Oh, well, another thing Tarzan has to do is swing across the forest on one of those hanging vines. Can you do that?
Of course.
One hanging vine coming up. There we are. What about that, eh? Go.
Terrific.
Go on, then. Grab hold of it and do your stuff.
Okay, then.
Yes.
Oh, Basil, I mean, you're going to be very pleased about this.
Oh,
you really will be.
Yeah.
I mean, I can't wait for this. I just can't wait.
Good.
Are you ready?
I'm ready when you are, Pally.
Hey, hang on.
Yes, I should. Very tight.
This will amaze you, Basil. Help!
Oh, dear, will he never learn?
Now, listen, gentlemen, please. A very warm welcome for Mr. Demis Roussos. Hey! Mr. Demis, nice to see you.
Thank you very much.
At least nice to see some of you. I'll take a walk round later and see the rest.
Now, Basil!
Sorry. I'm only joking, Mr. Demis. Have a drink of water. Go on, have one. Go on, go on.
All right, if you insist.
Yes, good. That's it. Marvellous. Now, break the glass.
Pardon me?
Break the glass. Go on, chuck it over there. Go on.
Basil.
It got.
Are you pulling my leg?
Me pull your leg? Take a bulldozer to do that, mate. Go on, break the glass.
Basil, let me ask you something. Why do you want me to break this glass?
Because I want the show to have an international flavour. I want something that's absolutely steeped in grease.
Steeped in grease?
Yes. All we've got so far is a producer's hair.
Yes. Have you ever been to Greece, Basil?
Oh, yes, Mr. Demis. Yes, I sat there in the tavernas, watching the moonlight on the Acropolis and listening to the strange, haunting sounds of the kebab.
Pardon? The kebabs, they don't make any sounds.
You haven't eaten the ones I've eaten, I'll tell you. Come on, break the glass. Come on, come on. Come on.
Okay, okay. Very well.
Go on, go on.
If you insist...
Yes. Demis, with a throat like that, you wouldn't get into the BBC Woman's Rounders team.
Actually, you know, I want to tell you, we Greeks, we just don't break glasses.
Well, what do you break then?
Well, we break plates, you know.
Oh.
Yes, we throw them against the wall to show how much we appreciated the food. And do you have any plates to smash here?
We certainly have. Can we have the plates, please? Thank you. Here
oh,
they come.
Dear.
Way. Oh.
Listen, I'm sorry, but I'm not going to smash the plates.
Is that your last word?
Yes, it is.
Cancel his check, someone, please.
Too late, I've been already paid.
All right, Mr. Demis. You win, I admit defeat. No plate breaking.
Oh, good.
Incidentally, how big is Greece, Mr. Demis, from north to south?
Well, it's this big, yeah.
Oh, and what about from east to west?
It's this big.
Well done, Mr. Demis, very Grecian.
Okay, Basil.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
You win. Let's sing a Greek song together. You, you know the one that we sung before?
What's that one?
Well, it's called Never on Sunday.
Never.
On Sunday?
Never, oh, never. The song will be never sung. Oh, I can't stand it.
Basil, it's a lovely song.
What? All those plinking and plunkings? Sounds like a plague of mice in a piano factory.
I want to sing the song, will you?
Well, let me tell you something, Mr. Demis. Oh, you can sing that song on some shows, because some shows are dumb shows. They don't care what they hear. But if you sing it here on my show, then I know that we'll throw you out upon your ear.
Oh, I've sung it with Silla, Roger Miller.
Godzilla?
Each time between he goes. I knew down well with Russell Harty and even Parky.
That's partly why it gets up my nose.
It comes from Greece.
Here we go.
Doesn't travel well. And it's a song of peace.
Doesn't ring my bell.
Atmosphere.
What a funny poem.
Straight from Greece to here.
Goes on far too long.
I sang this song for Larry Grayson. He praised such a gay song.
That's no surprise to me.
And even Terry Wogan knew it. We two did a duet, you know.
My deepest sympathy. You can keep the song for Foresight, or That's Life, or even the Des O'Connor Show.
Oh, you know, I sang it for the Muppets.
The Muppets? Those puppets? I hate all that you knew.
Oh, Basil, please, just please, let's sing the song again.
Don't get on your knees. We haven't got a crane.
Please say okay. Only for the laugh.
Very well, you may sing it in your bar.
Basil, see, we've got it and done it. We've sung it, we've swung it. There's nothing more to say. So I can sing it on a Sunday, Monday, a Tuesday, a Wednesday, a Thursday. Friday?
Yes.
But never on a Saturday.
Boom, boom. We are the champions. We are the champions. We are the champions.
Basil, be quiet.
Sorry, Mr. Billy. When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high.
Basil?
And don't be afraid of...
Basil, you'll get us thrown off this train, so be quiet.
What's the matter with you? Aren't you looking forward to the match?
Of course I am. But I happen to be able to conduct myself with a modicum of dignity.
Oh, anyone for tennis?
It's...
Here we are. Cheers.
Thank you. Did I hear singing coming from this compartment?
Yes. Don't you think my friend's got a lovely voice?
Oh, it was you, was it?
Huh?
Right, we'll have no more of that. We don't have any vandals on this train.
It wasn't me, it was him.
Oh, yes, I know. That's typical, isn't it? Blame the poor little doggy. There you are, little doggy. It wasn't your fault.
Woof, woof.
No. You can't choose your owner, can you?
Bark, bark.
Here, I hope he's looking after you all right.
Quack, quack.
Hey.
Gammy bow wow.
And you've been warned, right? Any trouble from you, mate, and you're off the train.
I quite agree.
Basil, how is it you managed to get me into trouble every time? I mean, I've had a very tiring week, and I would like to give my brain a rest.
I'll say one thing about your brain, Mr. Billy.
What's that?
You'll never let it go to your head.
About to strike that poor dumb animal.
Oh, I wouldn't do that. He's my friend.
Basil, the lady was talking to me.
What? Madam, I am not a dumb animal, and I'd be very glad if you'd leave this compartment and take that home for unemployed fleas with you.
How dare you speak about Frobisher like that?
Huh?
He's terribly sensitive. If you upset him, I don't know what he might do.
As long as he doesn't do it in here.
Basil, don't worry, madam. I'll see he behaves himself.
Crawler. I had a dog once, you know. Always fighting he was. Only had one ear. Percy. I forget what the other ear was called.
Tell me, does he always talk such nonsense?
Don't mind him. He thinks he's being funny.
Fat chance I've got with this script. Bloodhound he was.
Pardon?
Percy. Wonderful aim. Never missed a lamppost in the 10 years I had him.
Basil!
Used to teach him tricks, you know. I'm very good at teaching dogs tricks.
Really?
Does your dog do tricks?
Certainly not.
Oh, well, I bet he would for me. Let me show you. All right, Frobisher. Beg, beg. Stand, stand.
You've certainly got away with animals, Basil.
Is it my fault he's deaf? Sit.
Basil, why don't you give up? You're just no good.
He's talking about his sitting down, isn't he?
Yeah, but he already was.
Young man, will you please keep your mongrel quiet? I'm trying to read.
Would you mind if I told you you were beautiful?
Why, no.
Well, I would. I was brought up not to tell lies.
I wish you'd be more careful who you admitted onto your trains.
Is he causing you trouble, madam?
Trouble? I think I should go to another compartment.
Hey, the flea bag's going. Hope the dog goes too. You want to be careful. He could have you up for damaging British Rail property, you know.
Oof. I've warned you before, haven't I?
Listen, why are you always picking on me? Why don't you talk to him?
Oh, the poor little doggy. There's a lovely little doggy.
Who's a beautiful little doggy, then?
Here we go again.
Right, you. Now then, this is your last warning. What? You so much as breathe out a turn, and you're off.
Yeah, but...
Crawler.
Oh, I don't know. Bow wow, bark bark, bow flippin' wow.
He thinks you're a fool.
What am I going to do?
Pretend you're not. You haven't seen my ants, have you?
No.
I've got them in a matchbox somewhere.
Hey, matchbox? Yeah. I picked up a matchbox a while ago, actually.
Ah, that's it. My little friends are in there.
No, they're not. It's empty, you see.
What? You realise what this means?
What?
There's been a breakout. They're running around in your trousers.
Basil!
Ah, oh, don't worry, they'll never fit.
What am I going to do?
There's only one thing you can do. It's a slender chance, but you might be in time.
Well, tell me,
quickly. It's obvious. Take your trousers off before they get to you.
Take my trousers off? No, I can't
it's
do that.
It's an only chance. Use your head.
Yes, but it may not work.
It never has before, I tell you. Take your trousers off and shake them out the window.
Oh, all right.
Go on, hurry up. For goodness sake.
Listen.
Yes?
I'll be quick, but you keep an eye out.
Oh,
will
all
you?
Right. It's all right. There's nobody there. Come on, come
Make
on, come
sure
on.
Sure, nobody's
yes,
coming.
Yes, don't worry. Go on, go on. That's it.
Oh!
Hello?
It's the wind.
Please, remember, Auntie's watching the show. For all I know, there might be somebody else as well.
I mean, the wind took my trousers away.
Oh, never mind. Another four shows and you'll be able to afford another pair.
Excuse me, are these seats free?
Come on, I'll
listen, Basil. What happened?
That's it. You keep them in order. peace at last.
Yeah. All right now, little doggy. Yeah. The nasty man's gone.
We are the champions. We are the champions. We. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please, a very warm welcome for that superstar, Mr. Demis Roussos.
Just another day, I miss you more than I can say. I'm finding out the hard way, can't lean on someone else. I know it's my life, gotta live it for myself. Still I'm needing, needing can be right. Out of fashion to fall apart this way, and that I'm bleeding, and I'm not ashamed to say it, that I need you like a desert needs a rain, to pour your love aside.
Boyle of the Irish Space Agency are flying through space towards the planet Zog to defeat the evil bath vapor, Lord of the Filth. No one in space can can possibly compete with our speed, efficiency, and organization. Except perhaps the Freddy Laker, I don't know. Over to you. Radiation meter 0964, orbit control 70. Great heavens!
Basil, oh. that yellow streak.
Yeah?
Was it an asteroid flying by?
No, it was Busby.
Hey, yes. I'm getting a nuclear reading. What are you getting?
Flipping headache, mate, I tell you.
Do you know what this means, Basil? We're getting nearer to the forbidden planet.
Get away.
Soon we'll be meeting Quango, Lord of Zog.
And also Bath Vapor, the Lord of the Filth.
Right.
Yes. I say, my auntie saw a space object, you know?
Really?
On top of a 38 bus going down Rosemary Avenue.
Yeah?
There was this great big flash, and a young man suddenly appeared, all covered in gold metal. He sat down beside my auntie, so she said, can I have your autograph?
What? She asked an intergalactic being for his autograph?
Yeah.
Why did she do that?
She thought it was Lionel Blair.
And what did he say?
He said, I come from Venus. I bring you goodwill, peace, and brotherly love.
Hey, and did he?
He paid her bus fare. Come on, Mr. Billy. Let's beat the log, shall we?
The log? Yes, yeah. I've got it here, Basil.
Thank heavens for that. We wouldn't be able to go on otherwise, would we?
Here we are.
Right.
Captain's log,
yes.
USS Starship Nimrod.
Yes.
Sixth day of the mission.
Yes.
My crew and I...
My crew and I...
Shh. No, Basil. No. She might be watching.
Very sorry, Mark.
We were locked in the prison cell in Space City.
Yes.
The voice of the huge robot called from outside the door.
Yeah.
This white mist is none other than the mist of madness.
Huh?
A few minutes passed, but I just laughed. Ha ha.
After a few minutes of the mist of madness, he wouldn't just laugh. Ha ha. He'd laugh. Ha ha ha. Do you hear me? I'm mad, mad. Ha ha ha.
Because I
realised...
I haven't
finished yet. Now listen to me, Jim, lad. You laugh the other side of your face if you dare cross my path. Long John Saliva.
Because I realised a terrible thing had happened.
Crossroads is going to be on for an hour every night.
The toxic fumes were making us laugh too much.
Oh, I wish some of those toxic fumes could reach the audience, I tell you. Go on.
But for some reason,
yes.
Andrea the android was not laughing.
Oh.
She just leant back seductively.
Sisyphus duckling.
Against the grill marked air conditioning.
Oh, cool, man, cool.
I noticed the grill.
Yes.
It was partly made of plastic, partly made of metal, and partly made of intergalactic glass.
Oh, a mixed grill.
At once, I knew it was an air shaft.
Yes.
And a means of escape.
Yes.
I ran across the cell, pulled out the air duct, and I...
Duct.
No. I bent down,
yes.
beckoning to the others.
Yes.
Andrea, the engineer zip fastener.
Oh, I bet there's no flies on him.
And our three robot friends escaped with me.
Oh, yes.
Now we could run away from Space City and reach the nearby trombonium mines. A mysterious bearded man pointed the way and called out.
Oh, I know who that is.
Who?
David Bellamy. Trombonium. Twomponioi.
That's very good, Basil. Very good.
Oh, I'm a proper little right yard, aren't I?
I remembered that some of our crew was left behind in our spaceship, so I spoke through my pocket intercom.
That's interesting.
Calling Captain Burke and Mr. Croc.
Yeah.
We are at the galactic base.
Yeah.
We will wait till you join us.
Malcolm Watt was a captain, you knew.
Really?
You know what he did at the military passing out parade?
No.
He passed out.
You mean in front of all those officers with their pips on their shoulders?
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, who gave out the pips?
Gladys Knight. Come on.
And now the crew from our spaceship arrived.
Yes, good.
And we could set out to collect the trombonium. I explained how instead of bringing it back to Earth to be smelt...
Nope.
Special machines could be set up on the planet to do the smelting.
I know one person who'll volunteer like that for the shot.
Who's that?
Dirty Gertie from number 30. She's a great authority on smelting. In fact, no one has ever smelt quite like she has, I tell you.
Do you know what smelting is?
I don't know how to talk about it. It's probably because she's been eating some intergalactic garlic, you know.
Nobody saw us leave.
No.
So we ran from Space City, but we didn't realize we would have to climb the Zog Mountains before we reached the Trombonium Mine. Zog Mountains were like a huge range consisting of Mount Everest, Mount Snowdon, the Matterhorn.
What about the Matter, mate?
What's the matter, mate?
Nothing, chum. Come on, come on.
This part of the planet looked like Iceland.
I say, Mr. Billy.
Yes?
If your mother comes from Iceland and your father comes from Cuba, what's that make you?
I don't know.
An ice cube. Oh, I do like to be beside the seaside. Hey, look, it's 4B. I say, what do you want?
I heard you mention ice cubes, sir.
Huh?
So would you care for a drink, sir? At all, at all, at all.
He's getting at you. What sort of drink?
Mum's 77, sir.
I don't care if she's 98.
No, Basil, that's the drink. It's champagne.
Oh, I know what it is. I did go to school, stupid.
Yeah, but you came back stupid.
Come on.
You know, Basil, I can't take champagne. It's too bubbly.
Oh.
Yes, the effervescence does give one eructation, sir.
Hey, what does he mean?
It means it makes you burp, you twerp.
That gentleman called Zip Fastener might like a drink.
Zip Fastener?
Yes. There are no flies on him. And boom.
Oh, that's good.
Hey, will you stop pinching my lines?
Hey, his eyes are flashing, Basil. Huh?
It's probably that last joke. One wishes to hear a space limerick, does one?
One does.
A space pilot named Leslie Toms set out with fantastic aplomb. It was very soon clear why he'd got such a cheer. He'd forgotten to put on his comms.
Oh, I do like to be beside the boom and boom.
What a nice robot, a gentleman's gentleman.
Yes, well, I'll get on with the log, Basil. Now, where was I?
Burping.
I'll read on.
Yes.
I looked at Andrea.
Yes, oh, baldy bonds.
Shivering in the icy waste of the mountain slope.
Oh, I see. I think he wishes you could give us something warm and fur-lined.
Oh, yes, an overcoat.
No, kettle. Needs a nice hot cup of tea, poor Sue.
Soon we would be in the Trombonium Mine. But now a grotesque figure stepped out and barred our way.
Yeah.
It had strange black flappers over each eye instead of eyelashes and hair that kept changing from yellow to green to blue and back to yellow again.
What's she doing in there?
Who?
You know, Mrs. Slocum.
We were petrified, for this was the green slime Dactylorus.
The green slime Dactylorus? Mr. Billy, can they escape?
I don't know, because that's the end of the log for day six of the space journey. Will they run away from this terrible creature? And just what is this huge green animal?
The jolly green giant, ho, ho, ho.
Will one of our heroes fight the monster?
Yes!
Well, who?
Dirty Gertie from number 30.
Oh, they call it the green Dactylorus.
Its nails are the biggest you see.
It's going to reach out and claw us.
And its teeth need a jolly good clean. Here we are floating through outer space. Laser beams flashing at every place. Though computers may register zero, you'll never find a more fabulous hero than Basil Bruss
and his friend. We shall win through.
What? What? Oh, what's this? Riot in the streets? full hooliganism. Oh, no. Not the dreaded, the dreaded, the ladies' circle annual church jumble sale. Oh, get up!